Welcome again all of you. We have now come to the implementation part of random walk method. So let us start. First of all, as in always, we'll be importing some libraries. So first of all, let me import NetworkX. Import NetworkX as NX. Then we'll be importing random library. We will also be importing matplotlib in order to visualize the graph. So I'll write import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So I think we are now done with importing the libraries. So as in the previous programming screencast, I showed you how can you draw random graphs using NetworkX. So we'll be drawing that particular graph here. So I'll just write g is equal to nx dot gnp underscore random underscore graph. And first parameter is the number of nodes. So I'll take 10 nodes here. And I'll also take the second parameter. The second parameter is the probability of edge creation. So I'll take it as 0.5. And then we also need a directed graph in PageRank. Yes, in very first video, I explained that we need a directed graph for PageRank. So I'll just write directed is equal to true, since we need a directed graph. So next, what you need to do, I'll draw it and show you whether we are getting a directed graph or not. So nx.drawg and plt.show. So let me run it. I'll write random underscore walk dot py. As you can see, we have a directed graph here. We have a directed graph here. We can see the arrows here. But what I want more is I also want the labels of nodes to be visible. So I'll just write with underscore labels is equal to true, so that I can also get the labels on the particular node. So let me run it again. So now we have the labels visible also. We have 0, 1 till 9. We have 0, 1 till 9 since we only passed 10 as a parameter here. So 10 is the total number of nodes here. So now we are done with drawing the graph here. Next, what we need to do, as with the random walk method, we will pick a node randomly from this set of nodes from 0 to 9. We will pick a node randomly. So I'll just take a variable here. I'll say x is equal to random dot choice. I hope that you know what does random dot choice do. It will pick a element randomly from a list. So I need to pass a list here. So I'll write I for I in range. What is the range here? G dot number of nodes. G dot number of nodes. So this is the range here. So we will pick a node randomly. So I'll just write a comment here. X is the random source node. Since we have picked X here, we also need to increment its counter. But how will we store the counter? We will store the counter in a dictionary. So what we need to do here, we need to initialize a dictionary here. I'll use dict underscore counter is equal to curly braces. This represents a dictionary here. I'll also initialize the values of dictionary to 0. So I'll write for I in range g dot number of nodes. dict underscore counter I is equal to 0. Here what you need to do, g dot number of nodes and dict counter is equal to 0 here. Since this is a method, you need to pass the round braces too. So I also need to implement the counter of source node. And what is the source node here? We have x here. Dict counter x is equal to dict counter x plus 1. So we have incremented the counter to, we have initialized the counter of each node as 0 to. So for next, what we need to do here, we need to look for the neighbors of x, and then we need to traverse all of the graph this way. So I'll be taking many number of iterations here. So I'll have a loop that will represent the iterations here. So I'll start with 100, for example, for this graph. And then what we need to do, we need to look for the neighbors of x. So I'll just write, I'll take a list here, list underscore n is equal to list of g dot neighbors of x. Now we need to check, we also need to check here whether x is a sink or not here. If x is a sink, then we need to select a node randomly from the given set of nodes, from the given set of nodes present in the graph. Otherwise, we need to select a node randomly from the neighbors of x. I repeat, if the given node is a sink, we need to select a node randomly from the nodes present in the graph. Otherwise, we need to select a node randomly from the list of neighbors of x. So I'll just write, if length of list underscore n is equal to 0 here, then that means this is a sink here, it has no neighbors. So I'll write, then x will be random dot choice. Again, we have to select the neighbors, we have to select x from g dot number of nodes. So I'll write I for I in range g dot number of nodes. So we are also done with it. We have handled the case if x is a sink. Else, what we will do, we'll select a node randomly from list of n. So we'll say x is equal to random dot choice list of n, list underscore n. Then we also need to increment the counter of the particular node. So I'll write dict of counter of x is equal to dict of counter x plus 1. I'll also increment the counter here too. Dict of counter of x is equal to dict of counter of x plus 1. So I think we have handled all the cases. I'll just write some comments here. If x is a sink, choose a node randomly from neighbors of x. So I repeat this loop. In this particular loop, first of all, we are looking for the neighbors of the source node. Our source node is x here. If it has no source node, that means if it is a sink, then we will choose a node randomly from the given set of nodes of present in the graph. Otherwise, we will choose a node randomly from the list of neighbors of the given node. Okay, So we have handled the cases here, and we have also incremented the counter of a particular node if that particular node is traversed in the random walk method. So now we are done with it. So you must be thinking, how can you verify that this particular random walk method reflects the exact page rank values? Well, we have NetworkX to our rescue. We have a function in built-in function in NetworkX that tells us what are the page rank values. So I will be using that particular function, and we'll be verifying that the values returned by NetworkX function and the values returned by our random walk method are same or not. So let us do that. What is the method used here? Page rank. So I'll just use p is equal to nx dot page rank. This is the method that we'll be using, and we'll be passing our g graph here. So nx dot page rank is the method that will tell us the exact page rank values, and I'll print p here, and I'll also print the dict of counter here so as to verify whether these values are same or not. So I think we are done with it, done with the program. Let me run it. So we have the values here. We have 0 as the first node, yes, 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, 5. Let me see. We haven't sorted these values. We must sort these values so that we can get a clear idea the ranking of node given by the random walk method as well as by the page rank method are same or not. This will be difficult for us to figure out by looking at these values. So I'll just sort these values here. So I'll just write, I'll sort these dictionaries, the dictionary p as well as the dictionary dict counter. How can you sort the dictionaries based on the values? Well, it is very much doable in Python. So I'll take two dictionaries here. First of all, sorted p, that is equal to sorted. I'll write p dot items, and key is equal to item operator dot item getter 1. If you pass 1 here, then it will sort based on the values. If you pass 0 here, then it will sort on the basis of the items, on the basis of keys. As we know, in dictionary we have a key, we have a value. So it is your choice whether you want to sort the dictionary on the basis of keys or on the basis of values. Since we have to sort the dictionary based on the page rank values, so we'll be passing 1 here. And then again I'll write sorted random walk is equal to sorted. Here we have dict counter as the dictionary, dict counter dot items, and we also will write key is equal to operator dot item getter 1. Here I will print sorted p, and here I'll print sorted underscore rw. Since we are using operator library here, we need to import operator too. So I'll just write import operator. I hope now we are done with it, and let me try to run it. We have the values here. We have 0 here and we have 2 here. We have 1 here, we have 0 here. So as you can see, these values are not matching with the exact values. So what we can do here is we can always increase the number of iterations. So let me increase the number of iterations. Suppose I increased it to 10,000. Let me run it again. Let me see, we have 2 here, but then we have 8 here. Then we have 1 here, we have 1 and 8 here. Here it is 2819, here it is 2189. And there are some discrepancies in these values also. So let me again increase the counter. Suppose I increase it to 1 lakh. Let me run it again. So we have 4 here, 4 here, 1 here, 1 here. Then again we have 8, 6 here, we have 6, 8 here. Then we have 2 here, then we have 7 here, 3, 5, 0, 9, 3, 5, 0, 9. So these values are matching to the exact values, but there is still a discrepancy we have encountered. That is, here we have 8, 6, here we have 6, 8. So I'll again increase the counter. Let me increase 1, 0 here again. So let me run it again. So we have 5, 9, 8, 5, 9, 8, then 4, then 6, then 3, then 1, then 0, 7, 2. Perfect. We have the exact page rank values. So you can see random walk method is effective to find the page rank values, but you have to reiterate it many number of times. So it depends on the size of the graph too. You have to reiterate it again and again in order to get the exact page rank values, the correct page rank values. So I hope that this method was clear to you guys. I'll explain you this method again. So first of all, what we did, we took a random graph, a GNP random graph to start with, and then we chose a node randomly. We chose the source node randomly from the given set of nodes. Here we called it as X. Then we also initialized the counter of each node to 0, and we incremented the counter of X since this is a source node. And then we took a for loop in which we will reiterate it many number of times, this random walk method. First of all, I took a list N in which we have the neighbors of X. List of N represents the neighbor of X. And then we checked whether it is a sink or not. If it is a sink, then we need to choose a node randomly from the nodes of the graph. Otherwise, we need to choose a node randomly from the neighbors of X. And side by side, we are also incrementing the counter of the particular node if we traverse that particular node. So we increment the counter here of this node X and here also. So every time the node X is changing, and this particular loop is iterating for many number of times. And then we took the page rank method given by network X so as to check whether the page rank values given by the random walk method and the exact page rank values are same or not. And then we sorted these two dictionaries based on the values so that we can get a clear idea of what is happening here. And then we printed these two dictionaries. So in this way, you can find page rank using the random walk method. So my only suggestion is to iterate this method many number of times. Only then you can get the correct page rank values. I hope this programming screencast was useful to you all. Happy learning!